Well, you all know that foot washing was a common practice in Jesus's time. It was definitely a mark of respect to guests. The guests who came to your house, you would need to wash their feet. At the moment, you won't have many guests to your house, but in times gone by, when we weren't restricted, we would have many people coming in and out of our houses. And each one, we would be expected that they would have their feet washed. Well, the roads were terrible, worse than they are today. They were dusty and dirty, and there was animal muck all over the place. And they were wearing sandals. Well, they didn't have socks. It was quite a warm country. Well, part of the time anyway. So their feet were pretty disgusting. So it wasn't a nice job for someone who had to do the foot washing. Usually it was the servant who did it. And yet here, it's Jesus who stoops to wash his disciples' feet. Here, Jesus shows us that he is a king who came to serve, not someone to lord it over other people. He came to serve and not be served. And he said for us to follow his example. Now, in the United Kingdom, this event is remembered on Maundy Thursday, when instead of foot washing, the monarch, the queen, goes out to give gifts of money for exceptional works of service to the community, known as the Maundy money. And of course, Alan Bastock and Gordon Walters have all in recent years gone to see the Queen to receive their Maundy money. And it wasn't because their feet weren't clean. It was to reflect all that they'd done in the community over the years. So let's spend a few minutes thinking about the way in which we can show our love and our service, serving others around us in our daily lives. So we think now about the Last Supper that Jesus shared. He shared the Jewish Passover meal every year with his friends. Being Jewish, of course, he would do that. And they would always break bread and they would share wine. But this time, this Last Supper, Jesus would be instituting what we Christians now know as Holy Communion or the Eucharist. Other people call it the Lord's Supper or Mass. So we have our second reflection. Maundy Thursday, the first time that we think about the Last Supper during the year, the way that Jesus instituted it. And that's what we remember tonight, that very Last Supper he shared with his disciples. It was a night before he knew he was going to be betrayed, he was going to be arrested, tried and executed. And this record from 1 Corinthians is written by St. Paul, and it's the very earliest written account that we know of, and we know it as Holy Communion. It's the written account of the Lord's institution of this sacrament. Paul reminds the Corinthians, who were very new Christians, of what Jesus said at the Last Supper. By doing this, Paul was helping the church to recognize Jesus' own selfless, sacrificial giving of himself, that he gave his body and he gave his blood, his very life for us all. We're here to remember all that Jesus did. The bread represents, of course, his broken body. The wine represents his blood shed for us. And as we take it into ourselves in a spiritual way this evening, a spiritual communion, we are to remember Jesus until he comes back at the end of time, whenever that might be. Next week, next month, next year, whenever, we don't know when it'll be. We're encouraged to ensure that our attitudes and behaviours towards one another are loving, that we share with those around us, especially with those who are less well off, to be generous and self-giving as Jesus was, to reflect all that he's done for us as his body, because we are on the earth now, the body of Christ. Okay, Charlotte is going to lead us in our intercessions.
So let us pray together. Father, on this, the night that he was betrayed, your Son, Jesus Christ, washed his disciples' feet. We commit ourselves to follow his example of love and service. Show how we can help people around us. Lord, hear us and humble us.
This is our God.